Welcome to the Reflector Channel. What you're about to see is my latest time-lapse movie of the International Space Station flying overhead. Be sure to hang around afterwards, and I'll share some of the helpful details that made these images so much better than the images that I've been able to capture before. And, oh, it would mean the world to me and this channel if you could like and subscribe. Enjoy. Well, I hope that was a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun to record all those images, and it was really cool to make that video for you. I wanted to talk about what I've done recently that has made the images get a little bit better and a little bit better each time. We'll start with some of the more simple details. Step one is making sure you get an absolute sharp focus image, and I do that with this Batinoff mask. Now, this looks pretty small. This is an 8-inch Batinoff mask. This is meant for a standard 8-inch Dobsonian telescope. And the pictures you saw were recorded with a 12-inch Dobsonian telescope. But I found that if I hold this over the 12-inch right in front by hand, I can actually still get the Batinov effect. If you want to learn more about this, I have a short video that goes into the detail of just how to put this to use on pretty much any Dobsonian telescope, or any telescope, actually. It talks a little bit about the history of it, and it shows how this guy was 3D printed. But anyways, the Batinov mask is a great way to make sure that you get perfectly sharp focus on your smartphone, okay? Now, all those pictures were taken with a smartphone. In fact, it's the smartphone that you're looking through right now. And that was attached to the telescope with this guy. This is one of the cheap adapters. Now, it may surprise you that I use the cheap adapter over the expensive Celestron XYZ, but I seem to have a little bit better luck with this guy. There's almost no flexibility in this. It doesn't bend or anything like that. It's made out of some kind of metal. And I've just found this one to be a little bit more reliable for what I'm using. My smartphone has the camera right in the middle, and it's a big smartphone. So it has a little bit of trouble getting centered over where the eyepiece is here. So I don't run into that problem with this. My understanding is if you have an iPhone, then it works great for this. So if you have an iPhone, go ahead and give that a try. I attach it to an eyepiece, and I attach the phone to this. All right, so this one works pretty well for me. But let's talk about eyepieces. So for the past year, I've used the Gold Line series of SV Boney eyepieces. These are 66-degree wide eyepieces. Now, I really like these because they have the big lens at the front. If you've ever used high magnification eyepieces, you'll find that they have these tiny little pupils at the front here, and it's really hard to use. This has big glass. I guess that's how they said big glass. But this 6mm gives you a magnification on my telescope of about 250 times, and that's worked really well for the past year. I had to use a digital zoom on the camera to enhance it a little bit with about 1.5x the 2x. And I've tried various combinations of those. But last week, when I got all these new images that are super sharp, I tried something different. I tried to push the magnification of the telescope. I used a 4.7mm Explore Scientific eyepiece. This has a field of view of 82 degrees. And I was able to get this to attach firmly to the eyepiece holder here. And what I did was I used just the optical effect of this, the magnification. I didn't do any digital zoom on the camera or anything like that. And one of my worries was that I would have the ISO setting too high on the camera of 800. That's the max I can get on my phone. And by the way, for attaching this to your telescope and setting up the phone and doing all that, there's a video for that I made that I put the link down below. So that'll give you all the details that you want. But back to the eyepiece, I thought that the ISO of 800 would be too bright. Now, if you watch the video, you'll notice that at the beginning, it's very sharp. And then as it goes on, the space station gets very bright. I think I've discovered that the ISO level needs to change throughout the flyover because it's getting a different amount of reflection of the sun. These pictures are taken just after sunset, so there is still some sunlight reflecting off the space station. All right, so to summarize, this past video that you just watched, I used the Explore Scientific 4.7 millimeter. This gives a magnification of about 320, which is higher than 250, but this gives you raw magnification. So those are the nitty-gritty details. I have links to everything down below, especially the videos that show you exactly how to use all this stuff. So anyways, you put these all together, you get really sharp focus with the Batinov mask, you get higher magnification with a really high quality Explore Scientific eyepiece, and you hold everything really firm on the telescope, and you apply the techniques that I discuss in detail ad nauseum in the video on how to photograph the space station, then I think that anybody can do this. You can all take great pictures. In fact, if you give this a try and you get really good results, please post a comment down below. Tell me how it's going for you. I'd love for there to be a time where everybody's just taking these awesome pictures of the space station, because I think with a little bit of practice, a little bit of trial and error, a lot of us can take really cool pictures. Anyways, like and subscribe. Clear skies, everybody.